you got some cowboy boots, and now you're wondering, what else can I wear to go with my slick new style? Well, start with belt buckles. Hey everybody, my name is Jeremiah Craig, and not only do I love cowboy boots, but I love the accessory that goes right along with them, and that is the belt buckle. Belt buckles are another great way to express yourself, just as you express yourself through your cowboy boots. And there are several different kinds that you can get. I mean, it's almost limitless. You can get your favorite football team. You can get your favorite musical instrument. Here I have a microphone. So, I mean, you have so many different options when it comes to belt buckles. Definitely, if you are into cowboy boots and you don't have a collection or a rotation of belt buckles as well, you better start thinking about it because it is a lot of fun to get into and also a little bit cheaper as well. I didn't realize how many belt buckles I had until I had to pull them all out for this video. I have 11 belt buckles and each one has its own story, just like each one of my boots has its own story. But before we get into each and every one of them, I want to share with you the kind of belt that you need to wear belt buckles the most comfortably and correctly. The kind of belt that you need are the kinds with buttons, right, that clasps down so that the belt buckle stays in and you can change them out very easily. Now, if you have the regular average belt that sews in the belt buckle, you can still use these types of belt buckles, but it creates a lump that's just really awkward and it's uncomfortable. So what you'll need is the kind of belt that has the buttons here so that you can switch out belt buckles easily. So now that you know the kind of belt that you need for belt buckles, I also want to quickly point out that your belt should always match your boots, your belt color, that is. So if you're wearing brown boots, you should always wear a brown belt. If you're wearing black boots, you should always wear a black belt. It's just, they need to match. I don't know, maybe it's just me, and let me know if you think that I'm being too OCD about this, but for me, belts and boots have to match color. They always have to match. It just looks weird when you're wearing brown boots and a black belt. So just keep that in mind. But if you want to rock it and you think it looks good on you, hey, God bless you, go for it. Maybe you can pull it off. I don't feel comfortable doing it. I always have to have my boots match my belt. So now that we have the basic rules that I go by when it comes to wearing belts and belt buckles, let's get into the different kinds of belt buckles that I have. Let's start off with my go-to belt buckle, and that is the vintage microphone belt buckle. I like this because it's really bright, it pops, it's got the microphone, I'm a musician, it just makes sense, right? Like, this is my go-to for whenever I'm on tour, whenever I'm playing a show, and even my day-to-day belt buckle, I just really like this. And it's sort of an oddity that stands out from the rest because this belt is one of those sewn belts that I was talking about. So in order for me to put this belt buckle on this belt, I had to take pliers and actually take this part off and then put it back on. And you can actually see a video of me doing that while on tour because it broke. And I'll put a link to that in the description and also up here as well. So this is my go-to belt buckle, and it's not like I can change out the belt either. This is on this belt for life until the belt breaks. So this is my favorite belt buckle. Next up is my third most worn belt buckle because it is a thin belt buckle going on a thin black belt. It's really the only belt buckle that I have for this belt because the belt is so thin. It is a Roadrunner. And I got this belt buckle and the previous belt buckle at a consignment store in Phoenix, Arizona called Brass Armadillo. If you are anywhere near Phoenix, Arizona, you need to check out Brass Armadillo for belt buckles. They got a ton and they're a really good price too. Several different styles. But this Roadrunner belt buckle is my third most worn belt buckle. just because it is on the black belt. But I do like it too. I do like it. It's very simple. It's classy. Does what it needs to do. I love it. My second most worn belt buckle is the Armadillo Guitar and Whiskey Bottle belt buckle. I really like this one. My fiance got me this belt buckle from Brass Armadillo as well. So this Armadillo Guitar and Whiskey Bottle belt buckle is just a really simple, clean look. I really like it. It's got the whiskey, the armadillo, and of course, you know I'm all about that guitar right there as well. So this is my second most worn belt buckle. Another belt buckle that came from the Brass Armadillo is Blushing Melons. I saw this one and I had to have this. And it was funny because when I asked the person to come over and open up the case for me so that I could, you know, look at this a little bit closer and also buy it, she blushed as well because there's a naked woman on the front. So I can't wear this at any like business functions or anything like that just because the woman is naked, but I really think it's quite silly. Blushing Melons, fresh and luscious is what it says right there. I love it. You gotta love it. Like, come on. It's so rude and crude. Oh, it's so funny. Moving on to probably the one that I wear the least is this trophy buckle from a dear friend's late husband who won it at a rodeo. And I don't wear it very often just because I didn't win it. But I want to change that because she gave it to me so that it did get used. And I want to wear it in his honor much more frequently. So I'm thinking about wearing it at my show tomorrow. So we'll see how it goes. But this is a trophy belt buckle and I don't wear it very often because again, I didn't win it. Another belt buckle here. This is real classy snakeskin. I think it's a rattlesnake. I got this one in Arizona too. I really like this one. Just simple. Like this is the fun part of belt buckles is that they can be simple, but they can be expressive at the same time. So a perfect complement to the simple but expressive cowboy boots that we all know and love. This is a really cool one that I got from my dad, the Iditarod belt buckle. This is an official Iditarod belt buckle too. And of course, Iditarod is the sled dog race in Alaska. It happens around February and March. And that's when I wear this belt buckle the most, is around March when the race is going on. However, I don't like to wear it too much just because the prod here that is supposed to keep the belt buckle in the belt is very short. So every once in a while when I'm walking around, it'll just sort of pop out, which makes it a little bit awkward, especially if I have my shirt tucked in and this is out and then all of a sudden it just sort of falls off and my belt is just sort of dangling there. It creates for very awkward experiences when you're trying to talk with somebody. You're like, oh, let me fix my belt. Sorry, I didn't mean to just pop out there. The difference is pretty alarming. Like we have at least double or a little bit more than that on this because of course it's not going all the way down around this area. It's only going right over this bulge here and that's it, which makes it really easy to pop out. There's not very much room there for the belt to actually hang on to. So either I have to wear the belt really tight so it's stays in place through tension, or I just have to trust that it stays in place. Maybe if I'm sitting all day at a desk or something, then this is a better belt buckle to wear. But if you're out and about, make sure that your prods are longer so that they stay in your belt while you're doing stuff, or it'll create for an awkward situation. Here's one of my newer belt buckles, the Triple Heart with the B in the center. I got this one from my fiance, super awesome, and I can't wait till we get married. I consider this my engagement ring, actually. I consider this my engagement ring. So I wear this every so often, and this way people know that I'm taken. Love this one. Here's another one of my favorites, Arizona. I love Arizona. It's one of my favorite states in the country. And this is an Arizona belt buckle that has the date of statehood on there, 1912. So as you can see, you got the cactus, you got the desert scenery, and it's just simple, it's classy, and it's Arizona all the way. When I was first getting into belt buckles, I was figuring that this Budweiser belt buckle would be an obligatory choice. Like, I need to have a belt buckle that says Budweiser on it, right? Because everybody does. But I don't wear this belt buckle very often just for that reason. And also because I'm not a real big fan of Budweiser beer in general, but still I have the Budweiser belt buckle because I feel like everybody needs to have one, I guess. And this is my newest addition, the horse's ass. I saw this at a Goodwill just like a month or so ago, and I had to get it. Like, come on, it's a horse's ass. How could you not buy this belt buckle? I feel like I'm a horse's ass sometimes to people. So this one is definitely a necessary addition to my belt buckle collection, the horse's ass. Well, that's all of my 11 belt buckles. Remember to make sure that your prongs are long enough when you get it so you don't pop out there when you're talking to somebody. And also that you have brown belts matching brown boots and black belts matching black boots. That's what I got today. Thank you so much for watching. And if you have belt buckles, let me know what your favorite styles are. Also, I just started a new cowboy boot group on Facebook. So instead of you guys sending me pictures to my email and then me sharing it with everybody else, let's share them all with each other first. I think that would be much better. So if you go to jeremiahcraig.com/boot group, that will forward you directly to the Facebook cowboy boot group. I'll also put the direct link in the description below. But if you don't remember that and you're just sort of on the go right now and you just want to type it in, that's cool too. Just go to jeremiahcraig.com/boot group, join my new Facebook group, and let's get to talking about belt buckles, cowboy boots, all the Western wear. Thank you so much for watching. You guys are the best. I hope you have a great and spectacular week and just have a great day in general. Peace. You got your boots now, you look so cool now, but what else do you wear to complement it all? Go get a belt, and a buckle will help. You stand so tall, yeah. My name is Jeremiah Craig, thank you for watching today, yeah. Oh, 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 you guys are all the best. Why don't you comment and subscribe and all the rest?